I am not a journalist. I don't claim to be a journalist. I'm just the guy with a camera in his bedroom. The only time I will call myself a journalist is when talking to some older relatives, and I don't want to explain how YouTube works. Besides that, I'm just a dude with a camera. But I do have a lot of respect for actual, real journalists. People who go out and do real research, especially those doing field work. What I don't respect, however, is replacing all of that with AI and just calling it a day, waiting until someone notices, and then maybe pulling down the article and just pretending like it never happened. This is what recently happened with the once prestigious Linux Journal, now pointing to a 404 page, but thanks to the magic of Internet Archive, we have the archive. Arch Linux breaks new ground, official Rust init system support arrives. Now, we will get to the content of the article in just a moment, because if that title alone is not enough to tell you that this is not real whatsoever, the content's definitely gonna give it away. But the reason why this is so disheartening is, as I said, the Linux Journal used to be an actual, real, prestigious Linux outlet, and not just any old outlet, it actually predates LWN, still running to this day, run by Jonathan Corbett, by about 4 years, right? Like, this is one of the oldest Linux outlets we have, and it's just turned to absolute garbage now. And I wouldn't be surprised if the majority of you just don't read them anymore, because frankly, they don't put anything out that's interesting. And especially knowing about this article, you know, it puts a lot of the other stuff they've done recently into question. But at the same time, it's also not too surprising given their history. Linux Journal shut down twice now. Firstly, in 2017, they announced shutting down because they weren't able to pay their employees for multiple months at that point. And then once again in 2019, when everybody was fired. Then they started up once again in 2020, now owned by Slashdot Media. So this Linux Journal we see here, this is not the Linux Journal that old school Linux guys would know about, that people might have read, you know, 15, 20 years ago. Those people are long gone. The people who ran it are long gone. This is not even remotely the same outlet. It's using the same name, and that's about it. Now, this article is supposedly by George Whittaker. How much is actually written by him versus entirely by AI, considering this is not something that ever happened? I have no idea. Only this person is able to answer, assuming they're actually a real person and isn't just using this face and there's nobody actually behind it. So let's have a look at the article and see why it's so bad. Arch Linux leads the way in modern init systems. Arch Linux has long been revered in the Linux community for its minimalist design, rolling release model, and cutting-edge technology adoption. Now in a move that underscores its commitment to innovation and security, Arch Linux has officially added support for a Rust-based init system, marking a significant milestone not just for the distribution itself, but for the broader Linux ecosystem. This bold step positions Arch at the forefront of the trend towards modern, memory-safe system components, and could signal a turning point in how critical low-level Linux processors are designed and maintained. In this article, we'll explore what this new Rust init system means for Arch Linux, why Rust was chosen, the technical details of this groundbreaking edition, and how it may shape the future of Linux init systems. This is written in a very formal, very wordy way, but to be fair, a lot of journalists do write like this. It reads like an English major wrote it. The only problem so far is the premise is entirely made up, and this is not actually happening. But to certain people, I would understand why so far it's already given you kind of like weird vibes, like weird AI sort of vibes. You want some more? You want some more AI vibes? How do you like dot points, bullet points, whatever you want to call them? Because this article's got a lot of them. And there's nothing wrong with using bullet points. Bullet points are a totally fine writing technique. The problem is when you use them constantly throughout the entire article. There are more sections of just bullet points than there are paragraphs, and nobody writes an article like that. Do you know who does write an article like that? ChatGPT. Honestly, to anybody who's trying to write articles with ChatGPT or these other models, just tell it to stop writing bullet points. The second I see 20 sections of bullet points, I immediately know something's wrong. And I've seen the comments. I know that some of you think I yap a lot. This is so much worse because this is explaining what init systems are. This is explaining the transition from sys v init to systemd. This is explaining Rust. And now we actually get to the content of the article about the thing they are claiming is being introduced. So half the article is just explaining the background information on, like, how init systems work. So now for the real fun. Introducing the Rust init system in Arch Linux. The Rust init system, officially adopted by Arch, is named Rye init, or a similar name depending on upstream branding. What does that mean? I don't know, because no one would ever write this. No one would say they would change the name of the init based on... What does that mean? A minimalist yet feature-rich init system designed from the ground up with Rust. Initially started as a community experiment, the project matured quickly thanks to the Rust ecosystem's rich tooling, comprehensive tests, and contributions from seasoned developers. I like my developers very seasoned. Core features. Again, more goddamn bullet points. The new Rust init system offers PID1 process responsibilities, clean and efficient service supervision, signal handling, and resource cleanup. Parallel service startup, leveraging Rust concurrency capabilities to start services as quickly as possible. Modern configuration format. While systemd style unit files are not directly compatible, Rye init offers a simple toml-based configuration that is easy to read and write. Integrated logging, built-in support for structured logging, compatible with existing logging frameworks, minimal footprint, designed to be lightweight, ideal for embedded devices, or minimal systems where resources are at a premium. Honestly, this Rye init system sounds pretty good. If it existed. Integration into Arch. The Rust init system is now available in the official Arch community repository. Which also doesn't exist. Now, for anyone who's been using Arch for a long time, you might say, oh, no, there is a community repository. I remember using that. You remember using that because 2 years ago, it was actually folded into the extra repo and doesn't exist anymore. So if you wanted more evidence that this is almost certainly AI, there you go. Just using old information that is very clearly checked to be out of date. It can be installed using sudo pacman-s ryanit, which is very close to a real package. We'll get to that one. Once installed, users can enable it by configuring the bootloader, e.g. grub, to pass the appropriate init kernel parameter, init /user/bin/ryanit. Arch provides tools and hooks to ease transition, including scripts converting simple systemd services to ryanit configs, and mkinit CPIO integration to include the Rust init in the init RAM FS. And again, the rest of the article is just bullet points, and lots of bullet points. Conclusion. A bold step forward for Arch and Linux. Arch Linux's decision to officially support a Rust init system highlights the distribution's enduring spirit of innovation. By embracing Rust at the heart of the operating system, Arch sends a clear message. The future of Linux can be both modern and safe. Whether you're an Arch veteran, a Rust enthusiast, or simply a curious Linux user, this development offers a glimpse of where Linux init systems might be headed, towards a future where safety, simplicity, and flexibility coexist at the very core of our operating systems. So, what is Rye init? Well, if it wasn't clear throughout all the times I said in the video, it is not real. People thought it was real, immediately post the article around Reddit and various other places, and people were like, have you maybe checked the source at all? Did you realize maybe this is not real? This is possibly, very likely, 99%. It's AI slop, right? That's what it is. It is AI slop, no question about it. And usually AI hallucinations aren't just made up from nothing. They are pulling from existing data in ways that is not exactly relevant to the current situation. A great example of this is the Glorbo situation in World of Warcraft, where a bunch of Redditors started talking about how excited they were for a new NPC called Glorbo, how Glorbo was going to change the game forever, how Glorbo is such a cool character, and then some of these websites where their entire function for existing is scraping Reddit and then generating an article with AI, they picked it up and started talking about how great Glorbo is and how excited people were for Glorbo. To make matters even better, they actually made an article about the Redditors reacting to the fake sites reacting to Glorbo. I think that sentence makes sense. That is not what happened here, though. I was digging around. I couldn't find anything. From what I can see, Linux Journal is the original source for some random project called Rye Init. But it's not the original source for Rye and Init. I'm not joking. Here is a project called Rye. It is available in the Arch repos. If we go to the GitHub right here, basically it is an alternative to things like pip. It is a package manager for Python. Also, it's written in Rust. We're getting somewhere. Now, what about the init part? Well, it has a function called init. Now, it's not rye-init, it is rye-init. But this is everything. This aligns perfectly. It is a project called Rye, it is written in Rust, and it has an init function. I'm almost certain that this is the basis for the information. Now, being a black box, we can't really say exactly how this happened, but I think the best possible route is it saw Rye, it saw it had an init function, it saw it was in Arch, it saw it was written in Rust, and then basically filled in the rest. I don't know what the prompt was for generating the article. I don't know if they intentionally made it up from the start and got it to write a completely fake article, or they asked it about an init system in Arch and it just hallucinated something. I can't really say how it happened, but this Rye project seems to be the basis for it. The far better question, though, is if this was intentional, why? Like, what are you trying to do? People are going to notice it basically immediately. And if it's not intentional, why are you writing AI articles and then not checking the sources? Not verifying that it's actually a real thing you're talking about and not something entirely made up. Based on this article alone, I wouldn't trust anything else the Linux Journal puts out until they explicitly come out and say how this happened. Explicitly come out and say, we screwed up, we know this happened, we're gonna stop doing AI articles, or if we're gonna do them, we're gonna verify them, because basically everything else here, it might be valid, it might be real, but it's probably written by AI. And if not, that's going to be what's happening going forward. So when it comes to AI articles, what do you think? If they're at least, you know, accurate and talking about reality, do you care? Do you actually mind? I would love to know, because personally, if something seems a little bit iffy, I'm going to question everything about it. But that's just me. I'd love to know your thoughts. So if you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, LiberaPay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me and Rust. What is this?